Bonjour, welcome to another Dizographies. Today we are going to look into yet another Disney princess, Belle from Beauty and the Beast. Bookish, independent, not looking for no man, but happy when one waltzes into her life, Belle is an icon in the world of Disney princesses. Ah, but who gave this French princess such a magnifique voice? Let's... Ahem. Oh my. Excuse me. I'm sorry about that. I seem to have a frog in my throat. As I was saying, let's find out. Paige O'Hara was born on May 10th, 1956 in Fort Lauderdale, Florida. Spring break, humidity, alligators in your swimming pool. Her biggest influence as a child was Mary Poppins. She often cites Julie Andrews as changing her life and getting her interested in performing. Later, she would discover Judy Garland, whose voice and style she would often be compared to. Paige began acting at the age of 4.
Well, actually, when I was 5 years old, I announced to my parents that I was going to be an actress. And I enrolled in a children's theater program. And along the way, I realized I sort of had a kind of a decent singing voice and started taking voice lessons. And then I went to a performing arts high school, which my mother was the director of. And so I had a lot of experience through school. And then I went to New York at 17. That was back in the 70s, the mid-70s, and that was very bold, and I was kind of naive and didn't realize how hard it would be. But it was wonderful. I worked really hard to pay my rent and pay for my schooling. I would clean apartments, and I would paint all night and sell my paintings on the street. And before you know it, when I was 18, I made my debut off-Broadway and creating the role of Della in Gift of the Magi, which was my first role.
In 1978, she appeared as Marta in the off-Broadway production of Company. In 1983, she performed in the off-Broadway production of One Touch Venus, and also made her Broadway debut as Ellie in the Broadway revival of Showboat. In 1985, she performed in 2 off-Broadway productions, Oh Boy and Oh Lady Lady. That same year, she was a replacement for the lead role in The Mystery of Edwin Drood, and in 1986, she played Atta Annie in Oklahoma. Around 1989, Paige read in the New York Times that Disney was holding auditions for the leading lady in their upcoming film.
Well, I had actually been performing on Broadway in several different productions and whatever, and I was a huge fan of Alan and Howard Ashman, and I saw The Little Mermaid and loved it, and they announced it in the New York Times, Beauty and the Beast, and I told my agent, I have to have an audition, please, please, please. And I went in with 500 other actresses and some stars, big stars, but I just had this odd feeling that it was my part. And I'm usually not real confident when I audition. I'm just really glad once I get the job. So I auditioned 5 times, and Michael proposed to me on my birthday, and the next day I got offered Belle in Beauty and the Beast, so it was quite a week.
The first I got hired, and the first day I went in to record, I started trying to make it higher and younger, and our actress said, what are you doing? Okay, Ethel Merman, you know, what is this high Ethel Merman voice? And I was like, he said, we want your voice, Belle is you. The most difficult thing was letting the guard down and just letting Paige come through, because I've always played roles where I hide behind the characters, and, you know, and roles like Edwin Drood and, you know, and Fantine. But that was the more that I just spoke as myself, is the more with what they want. Truthfully, I really felt my character came to fruition a month into it, because I didn't have a beast yet, and I was recording for a month. And the day that Robbie Benson came into the studio was when it all clicked. And the two of us requested that we actually get to do it together, you know, record together. We just connected like we'd known each other forever.
Well, I was on the picture for 2.5 years. We would record a little bit, and then they'd videotape us. So that's why, you know, the hair in the eye, that was me. I had hair in my eyes and little things that they take, the animators take and make it real, you know. And then we go away, and we come back. And then at one point, they had finished Be Our Guest, and they threw it all out. and decided it was wrong. So originally it was they were singing it to Maurice, the father, and they decided that it needed to be sung to Belle. So that was about 4 months of work. That was, but they were perfectionists, and I, you know, that's why the movie was so great, because they would not settle for anything but the best.
Paige's performance as Belle is flawless, perfectly bringing out the quirky and kind personality.
Ah, Belle.
Good morning. I've come to return the book I borrowed.
Finished already?
Oh, I couldn't put it down. Have you got anything new?
Not since yesterday.
That's all right. I'll borrow this one.
That one? But you've read it twice.
Well, it's my favorite. Borrow places, daring sword fights, magic spells, a prince in disguise.
If you like it all that much, it's yours.
But, sir.
I insist.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much.
Mwah. Her songs, Belle.
Here's where she meets Prince Charming. But she won't discover that it's him till chapter 3.
And Something There.
And now he's dear and so unsure. I wonder why I didn't see it there before.
Are not only beautifully written, but beautifully sung. Despite these two songs being the ones Paige was most directly involved with, the title song, Beauty and the Beast, remains her favorite.
There even friends, there's somebody there's unexpectedly. Just a little change. Small to see the beast.
She's an amazing character. She was so far ahead of her time. And consequently, after Beauty and the Beast came out, Disney started writing their heroines as strong women. And I think that Belle really was, she kind of made the whole change. Started with Ariel and then really went there with Belle.
I think one of the most remarkable parts of the character that they wrote was the fact she really did not hesitate to sacrifice her life for her father. And I think that a lot of people don't talk about that enough.
Beauty and the Beast debuted to enormous critical acclaim and even received the first Oscar nomination for Best Picture for an animated film. Even though I think my animated movie was pretty good too. Where's my award? Paige remembers that the night of the Oscars was a wild one.
And then, of course, all the Oscar nominations that they had. And I'll never forget, I got a call from Jeffrey Katzenberg, and he said, your song Belle is nominated along with, you know, all these others, and how do you want to feel about singing on the Oscars? And I was like, I'm screaming. Well, they didn't put me in a dress that looked like Belle. It looked like Bo Peep. It was like stripes up and down and squared, and then these little pantaloon things that stuck out down here, and it was horrible, and these big, gigantic ruffles. But it was this famous designer, and I had to wear it. And I was like, oh, keep your mouth shut, Paige, just sing the song, you know. And I'm sharing the dressing room with Celine Dion, and she was very young at that time and just become hugely famous. And, oh, my gosh, she was, you know, like 23 years old, very poised. And she's in the dressing room, and she's, you know, talking, blah, 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 to herself and putting on her makeup. And they come in, and they said, Miss Dion, we want you to wear your red dress tonight because Angela Lansbury's going to wear black. And they were doing it to the song together. And she said, nope, I paid a lot of money for that dress. I'm wearing my black dress, thank you. Back to the mirror, and I looked at her, and I was like, how did you do that? Look at me. You know, I'm all these years older than you. I've been on Broadway, and I don't have the guts to say I can't wear this Bo Peep dress. And she said, Paige, sometimes you have to learn to be the B word. But right before I went out, one other Oscar moment, Angela Lansbury was introducing me, and I got to admit, you know, they give you the chance to lip sync or sing live, and I thought, I'm a Broadway singer, I'm gonna sing live, you know. I guess the year before Madonna forgot her words or something happened, and whatever. But right before I was going on, I was like this, shaking. And Angela Lansbury was standing next to me, and she was shaking, and I said, Angie, how come you're nervous? And she said, when you get to be my age, honey, you learn when you're supposed to be nervous. This is it. And then she just reached down to me, and I could barely feel it because of all the pantaloons I was wearing. But she patted me on the rear end, and she said, if I sang like you, though, I would not be nervous. So it was so sweet.
After Beauty and the Beast, Paige continued to perform on and off Broadway. Most notably, in 1995, she took over the role of Fantine in the original production of the ever-cheerful Les Misérables. She also reprised her role as Belle in sequels and video games, all the way to Ralph Breaks the Internet in 2018. In 2007, Paige also appeared as a cameo in Enchanted.
I've always been in love with you.
Don't you have any self-respect?
I don't need self-respect. I just need your lips against mine.
Wait, sire. Go back. Please.
How could I love a man who doesn't even like himself?
In 2006, Paige joined the cast of Menopause the Musical in Las Vegas and performed there until 2015. In 2011, Paige was inducted as a Disney legend. Paige's biggest achievement outside of her performing is her art career, which has taken a front seat in recent years.
Michael and I had an event where I was meeting with Rodel, one of the famous Disney fine art artists, and he said, I know that you have beautiful paintings because I've seen some of the Christmas cards you've made. And anyway, Michael worked it out that I'd bring one of my paintings, which is the Belle by Belle, which you'll see out there. And Rodel was very kind to let me have my art next to his, and it sold right away. And Michael Young was there that night, who's the head of Disney Fine Art, and he said, let's talk. And I signed with Disney Fine Art 2 years ago. So now I'm painting Beauty and the Beast oil paintings pretty much for a whole second full-time job. So it's great. It's a great honor.
Paige O'Hara's sweet and genuine performance as Belle has inspired and encouraged so many young men and women to be strong and independent. Her songs remain a staple of pop culture. And her sweet voice gives a camber to those very songs in a way no one else could. Paige is currently painting her most famous character, putting it on the hard talent towards keeping Belle's putting another talent towards keeping Belle's magic alive.
Thank you for watching this episode of Disographies. Click the thumbs up button below if you liked it, and if you want to be notified when the next episode comes out, consider subscribing. Comment below with characters you would like to see us cover. Further reading and references are linked in the description. We hope to see you in another Disography.